Hi friends, welcome back. Today I'm back after about 4 months. I haven't been recording any video because I was making my own refinery workshop, and I made my own furnace to process e-waste materials through the smelting and cupellation process. And now for today's video, I have some raw gold powder. This is impure gold powder, about 7 grams, and here is about 1 gram bead of gold. I'm gonna refine this with aqua regia to get pure gold, and I'm not gonna mix these two batches together because I wanna calculate yield for each batch separately. To start refining process, I need to make some aqua regia and try to get both of these materials dissolve. Alright, here I have 40 milliliters of hydrochloric acid. I add this to larger beaker and I dilute it a bit with distilled water. To start the solution of gold, I add gold powder to the hydrochloric acid, and then I start adding nitric acid dropwise, just in case, to keep nitric acid amount as low as possible. There is some fine gold powder in this dish. Just to make sure I transfer all gold particles. In this beaker I have about 20 milliliters of hydrochloric acid, and let's dilute it a bit. I've already hammered these two bits to provide more surface area for acid digestion. Total weight of gold for this batch is 1 gram and this one is 7 gram. And let's see how much pure gold we will get out of these two batches. Start heating the solution up. After warming the solution a bit, I will start adding nitric acid dropwise to start digestion of gold. I forgot to mention that this gold, 7 gram batch here, is the gold I've got from the parting process using silver. Actually, this came from the dore material from the cupellation process. So the most dominant impurity in this batch is litharge, or lead oxide, which needs to be removed to get pure gold. And also, I like to show you guys here, I have silver chloride precipitated in this bucket. As you can see, it's a lot of silver, more than 100 grams probably. Yeah, there is silver here. Now solution is warmed up, and I think it's time to add nitric acid. Alright, I let this solution sit overnight for two little gold beads get dissolved over the night. And here is clean solution with no remaining gold traces. And this one is pretty impure. There's lots of impurities at the bottom, needs to be filtered off. And here, this is the way I filter solution to clean that. First, I cut this coffee filter. I need one side of this filter paper, and I use a sintered glass funnel, and I measure dimensions for these, and after that I cut the circle. Before I start filtration, I need to clear this solution. I use sulfuric acid to precipitate lead sulfate. As I said before, the dominant impurity in this batches is lead. I just start adding some diluted sulfuric acid. Let's wash the white glass first. Alright. And here I have dilute sulfuric acid. After addition of sulfuric acid, it needs a time to form and settle down lead impurities. Solution got turbid a bit, but not a big reaction for this one. They are ready for filtration. Here is a coffee filter I cut. I place it inside of sinter glass. This will catch all of lead sulfate easily, and I spray some water on the top to fit it perfectly. Now I start pouring solution carefully at the middle. Now it's time to filter second batch. Filtration is done. Solution isn't crystal clear though, but it's good enough to precipitate gold, and these nanoparticles of lead sulfate would not gonna be a big deal. It can be fixed through last washing step. To start precipitating gold, I heat up solution, both solution. This one is much more clear. After getting warm a bit, I neutralize excess nitric acid and I drop gold. Here are impurities, mostly litharge or lead oxide, came from cupellation process and left after parting process, because this stuff is hard to get dissolved in acid. and here is impurities. Gold dissolve in aqua regia, but litharge is still here. This is about 800 milligrams of impurities. So for sure we know that our gold amount reduced by 800 milligrams. To see what actually yield is, both solution are warm enough now. It's time to neutralize nitric acid. This is a sulfamic acid I've already dissolved in some water. Let's pour some sulfamic acid in solution. It seems there is not much nitric acid in solution because I added nitric acid drop wise, and as you can see there is not much bubbles coming out of this solution. Now it's time to precipitate gold. This is ferrous sulfate or iron sulfate. I prefer to precipitate my gold using iron sulfate. I close it tightly to prevent oxidation, and this is my unique method of precipitating gold. You may not like this, but this works great for me and gave me the gold of high purity with 995 purity of gold. I use iron sulfate the way it is in the dry form, and I just add iron sulfate and let it sit at the bottom of beaker to react with solution and precipitate gold. I realized that when I leave iron sulfate still at the bottom, it yields much bigger gold particles, which is much easier to be washed in the last step. This is the reason I use solid iron sulfate and I don't stir it for a while, and after that, after stirring, I get all gold out of the solution. So now I start stirring solution. Majority of gold is came out. For dilute solution, gold came out of solution completely, but for more concentrated solution, still stannous chloride test is positive. So I use SMB as a tracer to get last bit of gold out of the solution. I use it also, I use SMB dry. Just sprinkle some SMB on the top to produce sulfur dioxide gas, help with precipitating last bit of gold. Solution is clean enough to start washing process, and stannous test is negative. Here is ultra pure brown gold powder, and the particles are big enough to be washed easily, and as you see there is no any small particles floating on the top. Excellent. The yellow color here is trace of iron ion, ferric ion in the solution, and I just tested with the stannous just in case. old powder is dried, and here is nice looking gold powder of high purity. Beautiful. And same for this one, some salt crusted out at the bottom. This is from the hydrochloric acid washing step, but this is not big deal. This will melt down and goes into the slag layer while melting. Let's weight them up. All right, this was 1 gram of gold. Look at that nice color. Before purifying, and let's see how much gold it is after being purified. Yes, this weighs about 1 gram, and here is our pure gold. Let's check this out. And this weighs 6.15. As I said, the starting material was about 7 grams of impure gold, and here is majority of that impurities which been separated, and here is pure gold powder. Add impurities on the scale. Yeah, this weighs 6.97. To melt them out, I'm going to add both powder in one dish because they come from same process but different materials. Grams of gold. That's beautiful. The total weight is reduced due to the removing moisture and some salt impurity from the washing step. And here is solid pure gold. This quick video is done, and that was my method of refining gold after getting gold from cupellation process. Hope you enjoyed. See you next time.